standing, or sitting rather, next to, I don't know if we can get this with the camera,
a porcupine.
I don't know if I should be anxious or not. I've got to stay away from the tail.
I think you're fine. I just, he's on a little run.
I was reading that news and I was a little nervous.
Now, my favorite part about this guy, obviously, is that he's a prehensile tail, different than what you're used to in a porcupine. And so that if he does get too far away, I can grab onto him.
Are those animals treats or are those just cookies?
They're sweet potatoes.
Can you introduce Dave Salmoni?
Dave
from Animal Planet.
Go ahead.
Hi, buddy.
Dave Salmoni.
Great talent.
Dave Salmoni is Animal Planet's largest large predator expert. By the way, Animal Planet is on track to have its best year yet. And this morning we brought in a few friends to explain what's going on.
Yeah, no, this is a prehensile porcupine. We do a lot of this stuff with Animal Planet, and for me, I'm always trying to promote conservation and animal learning and things like that. And so this helps us. This guy's like a little animal ambassador.
I've seen porcupines, but never one that looks like this. Where is he native?
He's a South American porcupine. Now, he
likes coffee,
to travel,
apparently, too.
And he's gonna make a terrible nest to your desk. Now, the big difference that you're used to, the North American guys, their quills are bigger. Their tail's got quills all through it. Now, and they're not long and skinny like this. This guy lives in trees, which is why he's sort of built. You can see his feet are far different than the porcupines we're used to. They're a lot thinner. Oh, take that, David.
There goes the coffee cup.
There you go, buddy. Oh, yeah, you're getting a little bit...
Does he just like to eat? Because he's been eating
He's actually losing his patience for eating, so we'll check him out for a little while longer, and then I'll get you to the next fun animal.
Dangerous? Not dangerous?
Well, he's dangerous. You see these quills? These things are to fight predators.
Right.
So if I was a predator coming on him, and if he felt nervous at all right now, he'd puff those quills up
towards
me.
Now.
People think that they shoot their quills. No. They can't shoot their quills. Right. They have to press them up against you. So if he gets upset at me, he's going to basically just...
Will he charge you?
He won't charge me. He just says, give me sweet potato.
And that is a he.
Yeah, this is a he. Now, you guys ready to see something else?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right,
this is a great example, by the way, of what we do. John Hendricks came up with this idea that everybody is curious about animals.
Oh, boy.
He's right.
Hold on.
He's absolutely right.
Here comes a bobcat.
So now we're not going to put him on the table because this bobcat doesn't love to be up high on the table there.
Yep.
Can I walk over there or should I stay away from him?
You can come over if you want. No problem. I'm going to try and get him to find a settled spot. Why don't you come out here, Mom? He's more calm around his mom, so we'll let Mom stick around, see if he can get calm.
When you say Mom, has you been with him since he was a baby?
Pretty much.
Yeah. So generally, most of these guys are kind of handleable and...
The bobcat looks small, but my son's here. He's 15 months old, and you guys actually said remove him because...
With all predators, you never want a child around a predator. This guy would see that child and just stalk it the whole time. Now, it's obviously not good for a mom and definitely not good for us. We try to teach all the predators that's obviously bad behavior.
But it's their natural behavior.
Yeah, you can't get that stuff out of it. As much as that porcupine was just thinking, give me that sweet potato, this guy's thinking, where's my next meal coming from? So you can see bobcats, because they are a shy animal, there's 12 cameras over here, and he's sort of, as they move, he wants to know why and where he can hide. Now these guys, because they're a forested animal, they're gonna be hiding in the bushes. You actually be shocked. These guys are all through North America. So if you've ever been a hike through any of the...
Yeah, I've actually seen them out here.
Yeah, well, but you're lucky because they're so rare. Normally, what they say is if you've walked 2 kilometers...
It was in Yosemite.
You've passed at least one, yeah.
Yeah, in Yosemite, there were several of them.
And Yosemite's a great example of a place where the animals have started to get calm and relaxed and used to people, which is great. It's another great place for us to sort of bring people to say, look, these are our wild spaces. This is why they're important to have around. So I love places like that.
You know, you say that you are in favor of conservation. Have you noticed an increasing awareness among Americans when it comes to those things over the last decade?
I think so, for sure. I mean, obviously, when you see things like Hurricane Sandy come across, people want to know why, because this is not a normal thing for us.
And
then global warming becomes something that we pay attention to again. Now, when, you know, Animal Planet and Discovery Channel put out these big documentaries like Life and Planet Earth, we know that the attentions to those types of things get picked up again. So people start falling in love with animals again.
We have to go, but there is a crocodile.
All right, let's get another one here. And I will...
Oh, wow.
Got that. I got him.
Baby crocodile. Whoa.
Now, let's get these guys nothing. Now, don't go anywhere near this guy's face. You can come around again. I'll bring him into the light. Okay. This is a crocodile, not an alligator. His teeth are open specifically because he'd like to bite. So don't get too close to these guys. You know, so now, this is not something that you'll see in North America. Obviously, this is the crocodile, the cousin to the alligator that we're sort of used to. My favorite thing about these guys is that they're so prehistoric. These guys haven't really evolved much in the last few million years.
Yeah.
Right. So the things that they've evolved to, if they sit in the water sort of like this, and you can see his nostrils at the top of his head there, his eyes are at the top of his head, and just behind his eyes, you can see those slits? Mm-hmm. Those are his ears. So a guy like this literally has evolved to sit in the water like this. He's got his webbed feet for swimming, and he just waits. Mm. Now, anything that comes in contact to those jaws, this guy's gonna grab it, and once he gets it, that's it. This is the largest predator in Africa. He can be over a ton.
Wow.
So we've all seen on Animal Planet where this thing's grabbed a wildebeest by the head, and that's sort of the end of that thing. These guys are fantastic predators.
David, thank you so much for bringing all of these guys here today. We really appreciate it.
Nice to see you guys.
Great to see you.
Good to see you. Thank you.
Yes.
We usually need to quote a stock or something to make it business oriented. Shares a coach. Currently 53.
Good way to get bit.
Coming up, the latest.
I mean,
Andrew's looking at that thing, thinking, "What a nice wallet." But you think, "What a nice." I know you as a one percenter. Yes, you are.